Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you all. At around 2:35, we will start our session. Our speaker is already ready with us, Dr. Tanmay. Dr. Tanmay Purdambekar. Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you all. Thank you so much for joining. Good afternoon, everyone. A brief introduction about our today's speaker, Dr. Tanmay Purdambekar. She is a renowned physiotherapist and ergonomic consultant. She is working as a consultant physiotherapist and ergonomist with Aditya Hospital. She is a faculty member as an ergonomist working with the Symbiosis Institute of Design. She has completed a Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Then to pursue her higher education, she went to UK. And she took the degree in the Human Factor Ergonomics. Even she has, till date, she has published many papers as a research paper across India, across the world in the international conference, national conferences. She is a good friend of mine. And thank you so much, Dr. Tanmay, for being present here and giving us your valuable time. The human factor ergonomics is all about. She conduct audit, she take the trainings. Also, she is now, I'm very proud to announce that as an ergonomic auditor, because training already the BFT physiotherapy was conducting as an ergonomic training for the IT industries and various other industries also I was conducting under the BFT. But now I'm very much happy to announce that Dr. Tanmay is going to be in association with the BActive since 2020. We both conduct ergonomic training, then there is an ergonomic audit, so along with the same, there is a designing of the furniture. Definitely in an elaborated manner, we are going to understand from her because she is also the senior most consultant in the physiotherapy and in the field of ergonomics. Without wasting much time, I hand over this session to our today's speaker, Dr. Tanmay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. It's my pleasure to, be here and be associated with BActive because as friends, we have been seeing this brand growing right from, since she has conceived this brand, and I think it's flying colors now.
Thank you so much.
It's completely my pleasure that I'm here and I'm sitting with you.
Thank you.
Let me just tell you one thing. She is the lady who had got me into ergonomics and introduced me.
Thank you.
As an, this is the field. So I owe her anything, whatever she wants, and she plays a very important role in my life as such. But it's completely my pleasure that, to be here with you.
No, she was a deserving person. There are n number of juniors and a senior I have ever came across. I had given my knowledge, I have shared as a colleague. But she is the one who made it and took that ergonomics in such a level that this is what I was expecting. Ki ergonomics is all about. This is for what I was expecting from my juniors or my seniors or my students who have come across. I have given the training for. So she is the one who made it, and I'm really proud. She's a friend. I have learned many things from her. She's my mentor. Sometimes she's my guide, and she's always been a very supportive physiotherapist and ergonomist. If I am not able to do something, she's there. This is what
friends do.
Yes, so this is something which I would like to share with you all. Like she's the one, and we are very happy now in the Be Active family. She has also enrolled her name. Yes, this is the time to work in the unity, and this is the time to team up. Yes, thank you so much. Yes, now over to you, ma'am.
So ergonomics basically is a very I would say it's a new field. It has been around since World War II. It has developed after World War II. But ergonomics deals with laws of working. So however you are working, in that there are particular laws, and those laws are applicable. So whenever we are doing any kind of work, you know, just reading, writing, maybe doing any day-to-day task also. So how ideally that task is optimized for a person to do it. So if I am short-heighted, the whole thing should be different for me, or the way I do the work is different compared to a tall-heighted person would do. So ergonomics is not only fitting the person to that task or the task to the person, it is all optimizing that whole work. And ergonomics has a lot of domains into it, but every domain deals with optimizing the work plus keeping the productivity of a person to the mark and maintaining the well-being. You cannot expect a person to work for hours and hours and, you know, be in problem. So it's a holistic approach, I would say, which deals with the manufacturing industries, the medical field. It is applied for design, it is applied for web designing also, it is applied for industrial engineering also. So it's a very varied and very applied field which has come up. Yes, nowadays it is more ideally now you see
it more, see it. Yes, if people are getting more aware about it.
Yes, but then it has been around since ages. It's only people don't know it. And now, because the appliedness of that particular field has been coming up since long, so it's booming up.
Great, great, very nice. I mean, this is what I always tell my patients. Ergonomics is not something which is very new, which I'm going to tell you. This is a daily basis activity. So the time you get up till the time you sleep, you have to follow certain ergonomics. So automatically it will act like an immune system for your body. So when she is saying it is since ages, of course it is since ages, because there are certain industries, there are certain people, there are certain professions demands prolonged period of sitting and prolonged period of standing as well. So both the things has to be in optimization, in combination and in coordination. We have to give it to the patients, or otherwise the people who are into working as an employees for that particular industry, there the role of ergonomics comes in.
Yeah. Course, yes, absolutely.
Yes, yes, yes. So, ma'am, I just wanted to know what ergonomics is all about. Like ergonomics. This is something.
Yeah, it is basically a scientific field. I won't say it is something, you know, which is purely based on common sense. No, it is not. Yes, a few parts of it. Yes, it is. But it is basically a scientific discipline which ideally works with whole data collection right from the people. And then designing the new way of doing that particular work, or doing that particular task in a way that it should not affect or the body, it should maintain the well-being and the productivity. So we basically, as an ergonomist, I try to increase the productivity as well as maintain the efficiency of a person, plus optimize the task and maintain the well-being of a person. So, aisa nahi hota ki, you know, you ask a person to do that one particular task for 3 times now, and then he lands up into pain and then say ki nahi madam aapne bola 3 baar karo to 3 baar kiya. So you have to see if the person is capable of doing it, plus does the productivity is changing or no.
Correct.
So it's whole combination of everything coming together, and then making that as an ergonomic changes.
So yeah. The overall lifestyle modification is going to happen with the ergonomics. There are many industrial training I have done till date. So there are certain industries ask for the one session. Just go, teachers, and then the part is over. It's not going to happen like this, because there are industries where I have done the training, or as a shop floor trainer, I have made sure that every year consistently for the 3 years I'm going there. Even the man,
that is important.
Take care of that, otherwise we don't accept those audits, or otherwise we don't accept those kind of shop floor trainings.
Yeah.
Because what we feel, ki once you start implementing, then only the doubts are going to arise.
Yeah.
Then only it is going to correct the posture. then the postural mistakes, and then the corrections are going to start.
So I would like to add over here is, see, for as me as an ergonomist or a human factor specialist, I would say everything, whatever you're doing, is a task. Until True. And unless you're sleeping. Why sleeping? Because you're maximally supported when you're sleeping. And that's the reason we don't directly consider sleeping as a task. But the whole body repair takes place when you're sleeping. But apart from that, every time, whatever you're doing, the body is still working. Right. There are few muscles which are working, there are few systems which are working, and few muscles are compromising, few muscles are, you know, maintaining that posture.
Correct.
So, when you are working continuously and when you are having such kind of work continuously, that one correction of posture is not going to show that, you know, the things are going to be better.
Correct.
Now, we might see a lot of, for example, IT people, you know, who tend to sit a lot because that is their job demand.
Very
and
true.
That is of course there. You cannot ask them to, you know, take a break after every 30 minutes because that is not, matlab, wo kar bhi nahi payenge.
It's impractical.
It's impractical.
Because they are totally loaded into that particular task and you are telling that person to pop up something and then you have to do that particular task. Of course, I am totally convinced and I personally believe into desk job stretches which I have designed from the person's profession to profession.
Yes.
We give the printouts, we make sure that we are doing it practically along with them so that they will get thorough with those stretching of the muscles. But it is practically impossible.
Yeah.
So their role which comes is a ergonomics.
Yeah. So what happens over here is you cannot expect him to directly get up and turn around and, you know, roam all over the office and come because
Correct.
It will link bhi toot hai.
Very
you
true.
Know, when you are in the, many times they are in a meeting, they cannot just get up.
True.
And
Very
then
true.
And then they tend to sit for longer duration.
Very
but
true.
But then as an ergonomist, if you want them to get up, first thing, give them a lot of water.
True.
Automatically
Definitely.
They try to get up. So within whole day, if they are just getting up say 5 times or 6 times a day, including
Correct.
The lunch time, adding water onto their desk table automatically increases the repetitions of getting up.
Very true.
Okay, a very simple tip or a very simple way of dealing with
yes muscle activation
with the same thing I am again asking them to get up
very
okay
true.
But not when they are completely cognitively loaded.
Correct.
I am asking them to get up whenever they feel they want to get up.
Very true.
Something like that, because
yes, yes.
These are the things where you need to manage and optimize you know, I would say, a human nature and human control and the work.
Very
so
true.
When these people tend to come with back pain and neck pain and everything, you cannot ask them to sit straight.
Correct.
I always say sitting straight, everybody tells you sit straight. Nobody can sit straight.
Because
Nobody.
Your spine is yes. So
yes.
Your spine will become straight.
So if your spine is yes, in S shape,
S-shape.
And automatically you can sit straight for some time, I agree.
Correct.
That is obviously everybody can do because there are muscles and those muscles are helping.
Right.
But it is very, very important to sit supported in that sitting straight. If you are
Correct.
Supported when you are sitting straight, automatically you land up sitting straight for longer duration.
True.
So if I am sitting at ahead of chair and like this, I cannot sit like this for a longer duration.
Correct.
I would automatically hunch and I would go back and do something. But if I am completely behind the chair and if I am sitting supported, I can sit straight for longer duration.
Very
so these kind of small tips or small ways of working are very important to incorporate in daily routine.
Very true.
Because these are habitual changes. Aisa nahi hota ki aaj maine bol diya seedha baitho ya supported baitho and everybody tomorrow starts doing it. You have to constantly tell yourself, no, I have to sit straight. Okay, then you again go back, sit straight nicely, and then after some time you again hunch, slouch, and then you again sit straight.
Correct.
So it is basically a person's, to get used to that thing also a person needs time.
Very
and
true.
That's the reason every training session should go for, you know, minimum, I would say, we should have at least 2-3 months gap. Maybe we should have that one interaction with the company
again.
Only to observe how people are doing, if they have any postural issues, if they are encountering any different pain after starting
our changes.
It
very
is
true.
Never, let me be very, I won't say rude, let me be very straightforward, that every person's posture is different.
Correct.
And every person needs a different postural changes.
Right. Okay. That's so, why in the clinic also, when the one-to-one sessions I conduct, Dr. Tanmay conduct, so we always suggest that this is your postural study. You come alone for your ergonomic session.
Yeah.
There are many patients ask me, why not me and my husband can sit together? Because your hormones, your DNA, your RNA are totally different. Your muscle structure, the length of your muscle, your posture, your professional requirements are totally different from your husband or totally different from your child. The adult ergonomics, then we can say the kids ergonomics, then the middle age ergonomics, the professional requirements, then the kitchen requirements, then the sleeping postures, what are the material you are going to use, what are the chairs you are going to use, what kind of furniture you have at your home, what furniture you have at your office. Everything differs from person to person and the way of using it. So the way important point which you mentioned is everybody is different, and we should accept that difference, and then only we have to design the ergonomics for that person.
Yes.
Because the main one sentence she mentioned in the initial stage, instead of forcing a person to fit the job, it's better to make that job such a comfortable, productive and a creative, so that everybody will be sitting and fit in that particular job in a very perfect manner. Perfect is never a word. It's always a good manner.
Optimized,
optimized manner.
Optimized manner.
Correct. Yes. Yes.
Sure.
Manner.
Sure.
Right. There are certain branches which we know about.
Yeah.
Like there is some physical aspect.
Yeah.
There are certain designing aspect. We have there are certain designing and everything we came across.
Yes.
There is a chair which we have recently designed and
True.
We are selling those.
True.
So something this is which we would like to know more about, ki why those ergonomic products are ergonomic, and why we cannot go for the random ergonomic chairs.
See, there are few checklists. When we say it's a scientific discipline and it comes up with a lot of data collection and, you know, seeing how a person responds to that particular chair or that particular, way of furniture.
Correct.
So, when we design it ergonomically, we try to see if all the ergonomic principles, whatever we are, placing, are they rightly mentioned there, is the design allowing me to, sit correctly in that particular chair. So,
right.
A chair might be very comfortable for me, but it might not be comfortable for you.
Correct.
Right? It might change because, see, as I mentioned, we have a different varied height. We have different muscle, strengths.
Very
we
true.
Also have different muscle tightness. So, there are few exercises or, few postures where muscles are tight and you tend to, go into that particular hunching, slouching or whatever.
Correct.
And the bone changes happen, and according to that you need to support. You cannot always ask a person to work ideally if he is not comfortable.
Correct.
Plus you cannot make a person 100% comfortable also when he is working.
Very
if
true.
He is 100% comfortable, the person is going to sleep.
For
it,
sure.
It is very, very, straight.
The rarest condition when you are very comfortable and you are working.
it never happens like that, because, see, obviously if you are working, there would be few muscles which are working. There would be, few thought process which is going on. There are environments which tend to work and which tend to affect your work. There
right.
is your psychology which tends to affect your work, the way you are doing.
Correct.
Plus, the work culture also plays a very,
very
important role.
Very
right?
True.
Ki boss ne agar suppose daat diya, kuch diya, and then you come and sit and work, it is very different how you behave. But then, there's somebody who just praised you for a certain thing, and then you come and work, you'll be smiling no matter who's there in front of you.
Right.
You would be sitting in front of, desktop or laptop, but you'll be still smiling ears to ears and then working, because that mentality also differs. So, as coming back to, the domains, there are actually four main domains of ergonomics.
Right.
One is physical ergonomics, so all these posture related things or design, interface related things come into that. Another is the cognitive ergonomics, where we more deal with the mental processes of people, how they think, how they feel.
Correct.
And how those feelings would change either the product or the ways we tend to work.
Yes,
so,
and there is a lot of creativity comes with the certain tasks doing with the left hand.
Yeah.
When you are in a group conversation, there are certain tips comes under that cognitive.
Correct.
Yes.
So, another thing is, organizational ergonomics. So, here as an ergonomist, I would design the whole system the job, how people tend to, you know, work. Plus,
right.
We also tend to see how that job would be benefiting the person and the company itself.
Correct.
So, that bridging gap is made by an ergonomist, and that is majorly needed over there when a company is coming up, or, you know, they are coming up with an organization, because human capabilities and what are the limitation of a person, what a person can do, is directly, it's an ergonomist job to see if a particular person is able to do it or no.
Correct.
So there are few job designs like air traffic controller,
right.
who has, you know, they, because they need a lot of cognitivity to see if a certain flight is coming, taking off, and
taking
whatever.
Off.
So they have a lot of mental pressure in their head, and due to that, their job design is very different from a locomotive pilot or any other you
very
know job.
True. Very true.
So where such kind of demands come into picture,
correct.
There as an ergonomist, it becomes important to, you know, help a company and be their consultant and see how things work
and how
you can optimize that whole situation.
Correct. Certain industries where we can say the more of precision work is required, like a pharmaceutical industry, the optical fiber industry.
Yeah.
Where the only finger pinch tip is more active for the throughout the day, and the more of brain work where the entire brain work is totally focused on the production along with the manufacturing departments, and there is a lot of muscle work. So there this goes in combination with the designing part. Like cognitive has to be there, the designing has to be there, and definitely you have to be in a good posture. Otherwise, that 9 to 12 hours duty is going to be very tough for you. So, this is where the ergonomics role again comes
there.
Yes. Yes.
Posture correction is, I would say, a very minimal part of, you know, physical ergonomics.
Correct.
But, you know, ergonomics and human factors also in this, it's a holistic approach. It is never one thing. So, if I cannot only say that I'm doing a physical ergonomic task, I have to include a cognitive aspect. I have to include the, you know,
organization
thing also, macro ergonomics. Everything comes into picture, systems design come into picture.
Correct.
So everything comes together to, you know, make a system or make any kind of particular job or a task to be optimal. So these different fields are very important when we are working together.
Very true. And it's always with the assessment based. There are certain companies have that kind of a thinking, why this assessment is so required, you just come and give us a lecture. Because to give ergonomics and to teach ergonomics and to train as an ergonomics is going to be the total different task. To learn the theory is very easy, but to implement in the practicality, it is going to be a little tougher task.
Yeah.
Because every furniture is different, there are 2,000, 3,000 employees we have to train. So based on everyone's requirement and based on the company's requirement, the mediator is going to be the ergonomics.
Yes.
Yes.
Another major thing is like these assessments are important because there are all different kinds of assessments which we use as an ergonomist, okay?
Yes.
There are few assignments which are only observational, like Rula Reba. You
Rula
just see
Reba.
A person doing the task and you just mention it as a tech sheet.
Tech sheet.
Yes. You have organizational assessments like OMPI or Swiss Tree Index. So
right.
It depends on what kind of, you know, job you are looking and how many months you are looking for that one particular task.
Correct.
So if I'm going in a manufacturing industry, I have to see what a person does there, because I have to observe the person. It becomes important for me to take all the measurements, including the control panel, what are the interactions, what all things he's doing manually, what all things comes into labor work, what is automated task.
Correct.
So all these things come into picture, and as a person you cannot imagine each and every system and give a very generalized session over there. And that's the reason assessment becomes a very, very important part into ergonomics. Until and unless you are not assessed properly, right from posture to the cognitive scale, including every person, what the person does right from getting up in the morning to going back to bed, ये एक बंदे का काम हो गया. ऐसे वो कंपनी में जितने बंदे होंगे, बंदियां होंगी, उनका पूरा काम एंड द होल. यस. सो वी टेंड टू कलेक्ट द होल डेटा, वी टेंड टू सी व्हाट इज द जॉब टास्क, व्हाट हाउ इजीली द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनी इज टेकिंग आउट, डज दैट फॉल इनटू द आरएसआई स्टैंडर्ड्स और नो, इज इट क्रिएटिंग एनी मेजर लेबर वर्क, कैन दैट टास्क बी ऑटोमेटेड, कैन दैट टास्क बी रोबोटाइज, कैन दैट टास्क बी यू नो जस्ट manually done with
done
minimal changes. So all these things comes after your assessment. Until and unless you are not done with the assessment, nobody can tell you the changes.
Correct.
So people who tend to, you know, I have seen people who just tend to go and say, oh yeah, we'll take ergonomic sessions. And without assessing, I really don't know how do they take these sessions, because that is very difficult. Giving, if I want to give a very generalized way, you don't need me there. You just ask Google what is ergonomics and, you know,
correct,
what are generalized things, they'll give you there.
Very
you don't true. Need you don't need any specialized there. But yes, as per every person, as per the company's problems, see, many companies have specific problems.
Very true.
Okay, so I remember one manufacturing industry, they didn't had any, none of the accident was reported within 2 years.
Yeah.
And they had issues with people's headache.
Hmm.
They had issues with, you know, the job satisfaction. They were not satisfied, the employees were not satisfied, and that's the reason they had called me. Saying
right.
ki, I don't know what's going wrong, because physically everything is good, because all the machineries what people are using, they are all ISI standards, they are all international standard machines
right.
that people tend to use, and then still there's a problem. So here as an ergonomist, I have to use different scales to know what is the cognitive, you know, way of assessing these things, and why and what basis the, you know, job satisfaction is less or no.
Correct.
So you cannot just give a generalized session
right.
to any company until and unless you are assessed. So assessment is very important. Once the assessment comes into picture, after that you can go for ergonomic solutions. So these solutions can be individual solutions also. And
right.
these solutions also can be given to companies on an overall structure.
Overall structure, very
so,
true.
There are a lot of companies who have started dance breaks in between.
Yes.
After ergonomic sessions and after these assessments. So, what they do is like, they start working at 9:30 and they break at 1. So, in between at 11:30, they have a dance session in between for 5 minutes. So, the whole company just puts up the music, everybody gets up and dance for some time, and then again come and sit. So many companies tend to have printers and water stations which are slightly kept away, so that, you know, a person, if you have
right.
to take a print, it is not closer to you and you don't do it in sitting. You just get up and go and bring
right.
it up.
Right.
Something like this. So these, not necessarily every company or
okay.
everywhere this kind of scenario would work. That
right.
is just one, I would say that is just one way of doing things which suited that particular company.
Correct.
But in manufacturing company, if a person is ideally, you know, if you want a person to take a sleeve and put it somewhere else, or you do some manual work, you will not expect him to dance and do while doing that.
Correct.
So there, because of that assessment, you will have to give some different way or
different
solution.
Because every industry demands on its own.
Yes, yes.
So based on that we design, based on the assessment part, we come across many issues which we can give up the solutions with. There are certain task demands, the repetition, certain areas are the environmental ergonomics issue. The high temperature, the vibrations, there are certain times it's the continuous AC. Like in the dairy industry, if you'll come across, there is a minus temperature. So we have come across many issues over there when the workers are working, and there are certain industries where the temperature is too high to stand and to work, because your tissue is life.
Yeah.
And you have to make sure that whatever the task you are designing, you have to understand it's a human body is working there, not
yeah.
the machineries. So based on that, we are designing, we are assessing, and we are giving the solutions. That's why these branches has to come in combination.
Yeah.
It's never a one combination therapy and assessment part is going to be there. This is for the layman purpose also I'm going to talk about. This is about industrial ergonomics part. When the person is coming to you with a certain issue at the clinic, so that time also ergonomics plays a very important role, because out of 24 hours, according to me, 23 hours is the posture. And that rest is 1 hour, like an exercise medicine. We are launching this facility and 7 years we have completed. This is what that live talks we have arranged. This is also what we expect. When you are doing a certain exercise, also posture plays a very important role.
Yeah.
If you are doing it in the incorrect postures also, your muscles are going to damage. So once you are coming as a patient also, if you are giving a certain assessment sheet to you, that picture study, if you are bringing those, you are going to come and then you are going to get assessed on the basis of that, and then we are going to redesign the entire task and we are going to give it to you. That's why that study is very important. It is not for the collection of the data, it is for the redesigning of your entire lifestyle.
Yeah.
There are certain doubts we come across from the patient's point of view. What are you going to do with my data? Seen your mobile account, what I am going to do with that data.
No,
but it's important for us.
I personally feel this one-to-one sessions are the most informative sessions. And
very
because
true.
It is one-to-one, because I'm only dealing with one patient, I am only thinking of his aspects of
you know
what the person does right from getting up in the morning to going back to sleep.
Correct.
So what are the tasks over there? What are the whole the way he travels, the way he sits, the way he has his furniture around.
Like simply hobbies, playing guitar.
Yeah.
Sometimes he's playing piano.
Yes.
But there are certain tasks which require posture.
Posture.
Yes. Else you will end up into n number of issues like
yeah,
a tennis elbow or anything.
So,
there is no other cause for that.
Yes. So I remember I had one of my patients who was a shooter, a rifle shooter. And he because he was into
sports a lot.
So he was training around somewhere in Pune for his nationals also. So he had a very famous national shooter as his guide, and the shooter used to say, you know, this is what you have to adjust within the rifle before you use it and all. But he didn't anytime look into it, and the same thing I told when he came, because I had to study everything else. I had to go to the institute to see how he performs, what is his day, to observe what all things we tend to do. And then I told him, you know, I first time in my life I've studied so much rifle for him, because I had no clue how that rifle works. And so I took his rifle for 2-3 days, and you know, I was playing around with him. Isse kya hota hai, isse kya hota hai, ye kya hota hai, what are the adjustments, including the manual,
everything.
So after doing minimal adjustments, he was like, ye to mujhe ma'am ne bhi bola tha. And I'm like, yeah, because that is important for you, and now you're comfortable shooting. So it automatically, not only comfort, but it automatically ended his whole aim and focus also. So he, after 3 months, he said, ki, now I understand why you say posture is important, because it is increasing my focus. So now I can shoot where I want to shoot, and that aim is
exactly.
Right. Because of the posture.
Correct.
So,
because
these things are very important.
Very important. Because once the posture is incorrect, the entire attention is going where the aches and pains are coming from. Or otherwise, if there is certain, there is a term in Marathi, rog lagte. इतका तो मसल अखडलेला असतो की त्याच्यात रग लागते, अँड दॅट मसल बिकम सो हेवी की यू कांट इवन होल्ड दॅट पोझिशन अगेन्स्ट ग्रॅव्हिटी. सो वन्स यू आर इन टू अ करेक्टेड पॉश्चर, ऑटोमॅटिकली 100% विल बी फ्रॉम द ब्रेन, विच इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर युअर टास्क, अँड द अदर पार्ट्स आर गोइंग टू पे अटेन्शन, विच इज मिनिमल, बिकॉज दॅट टास्क इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू रिक्वायर, बिकॉज यू हॅव टू अपहोल्ड युअर पॉश्चर्स अपराईट अगेन्स्ट ग्रॅव्हिटी. But still, you will become more creative, you will become productive. More importantly, the focus will be clear. You will spend less money on spending on the treatments for that particular task to get clear.
True.
And more importantly, the energy conservation will be there. So after finishing your certain professional task, once you go home, it will be more active.
True.
It's never going to be that you're lethargic, or I'm fatigued, I'm having headache, or my cervical pain is there, my lumbar pain is there. Nothing will happen once you're into the good postures.
True. One more thing, it is, I would like to mention over here. Many people, because they do that particular task in that particular environment for longer durations, they don't understand that this is going wrong.
Correct.
Okay. And many times these musculoskeletal, I always call these musculoskeletal disorders as slow poisoning.
True.
Because they don't anytime encounter you. It's not like accident ho gaya, fracture ho gaya. It is always
correct.
Like a slow poisoning. Dheere dheere muscles change hota hai. You develop tightness. You develop, you know, I would say the muscle tone changes from both the sides of the muscles, and then dheere it gives you postural changes.
Correct.
So that's the reason we always say postures are habits.
Correct.
If it comes into you, you consciously do it. Within 3 months, you would maintain that posture as your habit.
Correct.
But if you are not aware of it, it won't. So I've seen many patients which is or many I would say females working in kitchen or you know doing household work, they say ki haan ye to hamara roz ka kaam hai. So because wo roz ka kaam hai, they don't understand that that's a problem. Okay, not necessary because you're doing it daily, you have to do it now also. You can do the same work in different way. So correct. They have pain, they come up with pain. I am not saying they don't come up with pain. They say they have neck pain, they have back pain, they have this pain, that pain, whatever. But they don't understand that, you know, particular postures affect that pain on a longer duration.
Correct.
So that also is a problem. So I remember one of my patients saying, I have knee pain, but mujhe chalte waqt pain nahi hota hai. So I have pain only in certain postures, only in certain tasks. But मुझे चलते हुए कोई पेन नहीं होता. So when you ask them to stop walking till the time you know you are going undergoing treatment and till the time we increase the muscle strength, then we adjust all their routine.
Correct.
Thinking of you know what all things should be given as an assessments or what all things should be given as you know small tips within holding.
Within holding.
Yeah.
Very
so
true, very true.
They don't accept that they have to stop walking only because they don't have pain in walking.
Correct.
So these are small differences which we tend to see. Many times you don't understand that this is a postural thing because it comes up as slow poising. So many people might feel ki ha kabhi kabhi back mein you know spasm ho jata hai, that many times neck bhi akad jati hai, you tend to turn and it is there
into spasm.
Yes. So the spasm can be treated.
Correct.
Okay, that is not a major issue. That can be treated very nicely, but wo hua kyun?
Correct.
That is important, and the cause has a major. I would say the cause has a major heart of postures and the muscle activity, muscle tightness, lactic acid accumulation, all that into it a lot, and that creates a very major issue on a long term.
Right.
So many I have seen this classically with IT people, you know, abhi ka kaam hai. They work a lot if they have deadlines.
Correct.
So any product if they have to launch, they work a lot, they sit for longer durations and they finish because wahi target hota hai. They don't have to think that nobody thinks at that point, you know, I have to
maintain posture.
Something like that. So in such kind of scenarios, once a day you do it or once a while you know when you're busy you do it, that's okay. But on daily basis, if you maintain all these minimal things, I don't think it should be a problem. But
yeah, because it acts like an immune system for your body.
Yeah.
Like out of 7 business days, if you're eating the 5 business days at home, the home cooked food, and if you're having a outside 2 days food, so it's not going to hamper your immune system or you're not going to get any infection.
Right.
So, this is a generic example I'm giving. But definitely if you follow the continuous guidelines, it will be very beneficial for you and it will help you that extra working hours.
That's the reason it should be a habit. And
correct.
You know, iska matlab ye nahi hai ki danda leke koi teacher padha hai, you have to do it times. Consciously, if you do it yourself, it automatically increases.
Yeah, and body starts giving posture. Support to you now once you're into the good postures, because body get a lot of benefits out of that. So you immediately, the brain get accustomed, the serotonin receptors, the endorphin receptors, the happiness hormones are there. Every thing start getting into the balanced way and automatically your body start giving a 100% result and accepting. So 3 months, that means 6 weeks, 9 weeks is going to be the enough time to get accustomed to the good postures. It is not like any age going to get matter. At the age of 70 also we have trained, at the age of 6 also we have trained. So it's nothing like the age is the barrier or the muscle group is the barrier. It is all about your willingness to change.
Yeah,
that's it. And it is going to for sure going to give a benefit to you.
Yes. As I have also seen a lot of patients, you know, who tend to carry their kids' bags because the bags are heavy.
Right.
Okay. And I always ask them, ki aapke bags kisne carry kiye the? Because I agree the kids' bags are heavy. I don't say. First thing, you organize those bags very nicely. The things are half done.
Right.
Okay. Second thing, the kid is growing up. His power and his immune system or his way of dealing with fatigue is way more higher than a parent ka hoga.
Very true.
Okay, so his bags, he's supposed to pick it up and not parents. Why should parents do that?
Correct.
Okay, not because see, once a while kid goes into, you know, aaj mood nahi hai ya aaj bahut hi neck pain hai, once a while, okay, I agree, you support, that is not a problem. But on a daily basis, I don't remember, you know, my parents holding my bags and taking
this
me.
Is your bag, take it. You only wait.
Yes. So not because I don't want to go into the parenting
thing. We are not the right person to comment on
that. We are not correct person, the right people to do that. But I feel as a young person, agar usko chot lagi, so he is gonna that kid is gonna be okay or that kid is gonna be fine within less time because it's a growing age.
Right.
Automatically, the way the body heals, it is more faster compared to any developed body.
Correct.
Because it is more faster, they can automatically handle. And you cannot right. Restrict them from such things. I remember I always used to have, you know, my broken knees because I used to have cycling, I used to be on ground games
Correct.
N number of times. So there you cannot ask the kid to, you know, not do things and protect the kid.
No,
because that is what is the age. Until and unless the kid doesn't channelize the energy properly. Right? Uski energy rahegi to wo ghar aake pareshani karega. Something like that, because you need to channelize the energy. So he has that capacity.
Correct.
He has the capability. Let's not limit the kid to lift the pants. You can just organize it, because that is what they don't understand.
They don't understand.
That parents can surely do, but holding their bags and, you know,
right.
taking them to school, then it becomes a problem.
Very true.
Okay.
And
so,
there also comes a part of ergonomics, which is like a backpack ergonomics, which
yes.
we can prevent spinal injuries even in the youngsters. Or otherwise, in the lockdown period, I can say, there are so many patients I came across from the National Geographic, any number of patients we have done, they require to carry a backpack when they are in the trekking or otherwise when they are
yeah.
diving inside, or there are certain amount of professions require like this. So once we are training them, we are pretty sure ki that person is capable of doing that. And if he is not, then the physiotherapy is there to make sure them to capable. And that's why I always say ki physiotherapy and ergonomics go in hand in hand.
Yes, that is very important, because until and unless the muscles are strong, they are not going to
maintain the posture.
So it's always a give and take. That's the reason
Correct.
Any ergonomic field also, it is not only that one particular thing which goes into that posture correction or any kind of I would say ergonomic solutions. You have
Correct.
Everything as a holistic approach.
Correct.
And I'm sure this holistic approach you have to study until and unless you have that way of thinking. You cannot be an ergonomist.
Correct.
You should have that way. You should know that what is the data problem over here. You should go and collect the assessments. After collecting the assessments, apply all the principles over there and see what is the problem, and then give an ergonomic solution.
Correct.
You cannot just say sitting straight is an ergonomic solution.
Correct.
Okay. Meri dadi ko poocho, wo bhi bolegi seedha baitho.
Very true. And there are certain tasks like simply reading, writing, typing, working on a smartphone, working on the laptop, working on the computer, sleeping and working. Sitting on the bed and working, sitting on the chair and working, learn ergonomics, because we are not the farmers who are working in the 3-3 hours in the farm and then you are expecting your body to be so much flexible like the previous era. It's not going to happen, because why there is a necessity of ergonomics? Because now we are becoming more sedentary.
Yeah.
Why there is a necessity of learning ergonomics? Because you have to be fit at least up to the minimal age of your life. Because the lifespan is increasing.
Maximum age. Whatever we think is maximum.
Right. You should be healthy, you should
yes.
be fit, and you
yes.
should be able to do the entire task. Like simply you want to do trekking, have a good trekker shoes, but that shoes has to be ergonomic. Else the shock absorption will not be there. You will not be able to climb up. And your speed will get reduced. So there are certain aspects, like the marathon runners who visit, there are football players who visit as a sports physiotherapy, that I came across many people. Good brand, but it's not suitable for you, dear. If it is suitable, then only we can design it for you. Then the things comes under that, this is something which you have to go for. If we find it comfortable, then only we'll give that assessment clearance, otherwise no. You cannot force us to give that, because you will be in trouble. That performance will get reduced, and this is how exactly the ergonomics field works.
Yeah.
Because that thing has to be snugly fit to the person who is using it. Otherwise, it's just a waste. How many thousands you spend on?
True.
Right.
It is very important to see which brand, because every brand has their specific way of making those shoes.
Correct.
And of course, because it's a brand and they have whole manufacturing unit, they don't tell you each and every minute details, what they tend to think and how an R&D goes into making shoes also. Not necessarily a brand which is actually comfortable for me should be comfortable for you also.
Correct.
So that changes, and it also depends on how your leg arches, how
correct.
Is your weight going on with side,
with
of, the
side
foot.
Of the foot.
So if you're running on your heels or you're running on your toes. So all these things come into picture. These assessments are important
correct.
To know how the person runs and then give a shoe particular to that particular runner. Okay. So there's huge study going into all these things. There
right,
are huge,
right.
huge manufacturing brands who tend to, you know, have a huge study.
Right.
There are people who are creating shoes specifically for the South African people, because they are tall enough, they run in a very different way compared to how we run.
Yeah,
so,
very true.
The way of running is also changing. So you need to see all these things into picture to
there are
suggest any particular shoe.
Shoes, very
yes.
true. There are certain basics of ergonomics for the chappals and the footwear which I have taken the international webinar and that I have cropped up and I put it on my YouTube channel for you all. Is because to cover the entire topic in this such a small session from the experts, so it's becoming very difficult. Because there are certain aspects of it which you have to cover. And footwear which I found it, which is a necessity for the nowadays, because knee pain, hip pain, back pain, neck pain, everything is associated with the weight bearing, the center of gravity which is passing through you and your footwear which you are using at home or otherwise in outside. So I will request you all to do go watch those videos and get the corrections and the basic guidelines, what is good for me. That only you can go for. Otherwise, and you have certain pathological condition, there are experts like us. We are there to take an assessment. We will design it for you and we will give the correct insoles to you.
True.
Yes.
I have also seen patients which tend to say ki हमारे पुराने जनरेशन को ये सब नहीं हुआ तो हमें क्यों हुआ.
This is the commonest
one.
This is very
common. Very common. I still say my dadaji was at 96 when he expired, but he didn't have BP.
No.
He didn't have diabetes. He used to only eat sweets.
Right.
My daddy now also doesn't have BP and diabetes, but my mom dad would catch it prior.
Correct.
Okay. So I might be in my 30s, mid-30s, I might also land up with
similar
things. See, we have lifestyle changes which are major. Okay. Especially our generation now, which has major lifestyle. Maybe the younger generation will have more different lifestyle. So the whole change within these three generations and the lifestyle change, the way we cook or the way we eat,
correct.
Right from whatever we are eating till however we are, sleeping, we have whole lifestyle changes, and that's very important to take into, you know, grant and take into thought when we are saying such kind of statements. The work what they used to do and the work what we do, how their body was trained, how our body was trained is very different. They were all trained for that particular, amount of work with what they used
right.
to do. Because pani nahi tha, to kahin aur jaake pani leke aana padta tha. So their body automatically had that capabilities and had developed that strength for that particular task. And that's the reason they had a lot of labor tasks also which they used to do for
right.
simple living.
Because simply urbanized and the people who are living into the small cities,
yeah.
their lifestyle is also different.
Yes, yes.
So it is
right.
not going to remain same everywhere.
Right. And that's the reason we at our age has different kind of problems and people at different age has different kinds
different
of problems.
Kinds of problems.
And
very
hence
true.
It cannot be clubbed together. And many times, you know, you automatically say we tend to eat same food because we live together, but still we have issues. That is all because of our lifestyle.
Correct, correct.
Plus, we are here where our body now is going to change in a degenerative manner.
Very true.
Okay. Older generation, their body is already degenerated now and they
correct.
Might face issues. But now because we have come up to a phase where our development has been done and now it is a stable plateau phase.
Correct.
Here we are, what we can do from our side is only maintain things.
Maintain things.
So, you know,
so
having exercise and throughout the day, having, having good amount of fruits and food, decreasing the junk food within our
correct.
Whole day. This all things become so much important for us. All these things, I think it has come up now, junk food and all. It's not like Earlier it wasn't there, it was there, but the way we used to go out and have those junk food was very less.
Very less, very less.
Now it is quite, I would say it's more, and that's the reason
it's
we are facing all these issues.
People are taking it more easily.
Yeah.
And now without even bothering it's a junk, people are consuming it.
Yes.
So
the frequency of having such kind of things has more and that has changed the whole
lifestyle.
So because there's a huge change in the lifestyle, that's the reason we face these issues. Ki unko kabhi tha nahi and hame hai.
Right.
So hame hai because our lifestyle is very different and
correct.
We need to change it, we need to control it, which people don't do usually.
Correct.
I think so. This plays a very important role also because it's as I mentioned, it's a whole holistic approach what we see.
Right. So on the summation of this session, what we can say is this: the ergonomics and the physiotherapy aspects go hand in hand. The approach has to be totally holistic. The second most important is as whenever you are in pain or in a certain issues, you have to approach the specialist into that field, not to Google them. And the third thing is that there are certain aspects which you can correct it from the root, which where you need a help of the ergonomics. So definitely seek that help, correct your postures and strengthen your muscles. Whether you are into the fitness industry, whether you are into the any kind of an other industries like IT or the manufacturing or any other. So everywhere postures are required. So correct your posture, then strengthen your muscles is going to make you healthy for the and maintaining the well-being of your life.
True.
So now ma'am, there are certain questions are coming, I guess people have posted in the comment box. Now it's the audience, your time and your viewers. Now you can ask us the questions. We have done with the ergonomics basic introductory session. If any doubts, anything, we are here to answer all the questions. Already some has posted. I'll read it and ma'am will answer it.
Sure, sure. Of course.
Yes. Yes, there is a one question from the one of the doctor. There is a question he has asked ki, if the person has a habit of lying down so frequently, so how much time it will take for that person to correct the posture and how much time it will take for it?
So if a person is lying down frequently, see, this can happen if a person it all depends on what age we are talking about and what
correct.
Kind of assessment a person has, what kind of job that person has. But it also depends why the person is lying down frequently. He calm nahi hai, isliye the person is lying down, or they actually have some amount of pain and to relax, that's the reason they are
just lying down
to just get a repair kind of a thing. But in such scenarios, I would surely say that we need a detailed assessment for this. But in such scenarios, I think 6 months should be okay.
Yeah.
After assessment, 6 months should be okay when we start with minimal ergonomic solutions and exercises and the holistic approach
right.
and coming up. And within 6 months, I think it should be habituated nicely with including the what all tasks the person is doing, what
and
all
definitely
cognitive
the
load.
Frequent follow-ups, because
yes.
once the postural corrections and once the ailment is getting cured,
yeah.
need the next follow-up.
Yeah.
So I think
6 months after assessment should be enough.
Yes.
Right. Plus minus two, we can obviously think of.
Very
like,
true.
You know, it's not today we start and we finish in
finish,
6 months.
Finish 6 months.
So
it's
always
too early,
we are
more than happy for
yeah.
it.
Yeah, we would be more than happy. Yes, true.
Right.
Yeah.
So thank you so much. I guess no more questions. Is there any question?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Alright, so being a wonderful audience and being so attentive in the entire session. Thank you, Dr. Tanmay, for giving us your valuable time and giving us such a good information on the basis of ergonomics. Really, we are happy, and this is something in the future everybody can go, the nearby physio or the nearby ergonomics. Whoever you are visiting, you should be now having a clear mindset why we are going for it.
Yeah.
So what are the things we are going to do there and how exactly we have to correct our lifestyle. So thank you so much for giving us such a valuable information.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And this her video will be available on our IGTV Instagram. So if you want to share it with someone, if you want to go through it for the informative part, it will be there, because it was a query which was coming, ki, where is the video? So now video is in IGTV, it is not going to be on my post page. So you can go and check those.
Sure.
Thank you so much, and see you tomorrow now 2:30 with the new session, with the new speaker. We are definitely going to keep posting everything on our status, and the link will be get shared with you all. You have to follow the page, then you will be able to get the live notifications, and then you will be able to attend these kind of sessions sharp at 2:30 with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys. Thank you very much.